Hi there, Jamie here today at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day today. Today I want to show you how you can use checkboxes to create an interactive chart in Microsoft Excel. So what I mean is, if I go ahead to over here, if I go and click one on, you can see then that is represented in the chart. I can turn it off very quickly, add another one, or turn another one off to compare. So the chart is going to dynamically update as I choose what check mark I want. So that's what I want to show you how to do today on Teachers Tech. If you would like to follow along with today's tutorial, I'll put a link to this workbook down below in the description. You can just click on it and then just go file and save as a copy. The other thing I want to point out is this video comes in multiple languages where you can make the selection down below in settings on the YouTube video and go to audio and you'll see what languages are available. All right, let's get started with how to insert checkboxes into Microsoft Excel. I'm going to be using sheet 2 on the tab here when I go through it, but I'll leave sheet 1 with all this information so you can take a look at it and play with it before you even get started. All right, so on sheet 2, you can see we have the same information. The first thing we're going to need to do is add our checkboxes to Microsoft Excel. Now we have to do something before we can get started with this, and that is add another tab, a developer tab up top. So if you kind of hover over it here, if I right click when I'm up here in the menu, you get these options. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go to customize the ribbon. And at this point, if you take a look down on the right-hand side, you can see developer right here. And by default, it's not checked. So I'm going to select that, hit OK. And now I have another tab called developer. And this is where you're going to find the checkboxes. So what I'm going to do is now go to the developer and go to insert right here. So if I go and choose insert, the text box is going to be right here. So I'm going to just click on it. And where do I want to have it placed? Well, I'm going to go ahead and just put it right here. And I'm going to make it a little larger because you can see that there's text already automatically into this. And you can change this. Notice if I go to try to click on it, I can click it on off the check, but now I can't move it. If I want to move it again, you can simply right click and then you get the handles back and you can see you can have the move one to bring it to where you want. The other thing I want to point out right away is I don't want it to say checkbox one. I just want it to be empty here. I just want the check. I can go in here. As soon as you go in here, you can highlight it and just like other text boxes you're working with, go ahead and delete it from here. And I can go and make this smaller just like this. Now, if I click off of it, notice I can't move it again over. Now, the other thing that I need to have done here is it doesn't do anything yet because I haven't told it, I haven't set to what this means when I check it on or off. And I do want to point out when you right click on this again, you can see you get different options from your cut, copy, paste if I wanted to do multiple, but I'll show you a different way you can do this in a moment. But if I go down to format control here, and you can see we do have color and lines and size protection and all these. I'm not going to go over these things here in today's tutorial, but I do want you to go to control and make a couple of changes. Because if we go to this here, I need this to be under checked and it needs to be linked to a cell somewhere. So I'm going to just select here and I'm going to select right on this one right here and just go back. And you can see now I have that cell and hit OK. So if I click off of it now, that means when it's checked, it's true. So if I unclick it, now it says false. So this is important because this is what I'm going to be connecting to. Now in my demo over here, if I go back to sheet 1, you can see I had 4 different ones. And notice it doesn't say false or true anywhere. I'm going to show you where I hid those. So I'm going to go back to sheet 2. too. Now, what we can do at this point here, now you could go, you can do your Control C, Control V and copy it down, or you could go insert another checkbox. What you can do though, is if you go to it, once you click off of it and you have it in place here, I can just use my normal drag down to paste, to copy them down. So if I want, I need to have four different ones, there's my four there. But I do need to set each one up. So right now these three checkboxes are connected to this one right here. I need to each of them have their own cell. So if I go to this one and I'm going to just right click and format control. So I'm just going to make a quick change this one and I'm going to hit enter and hit okay. And I'm going to go to this one now. I'm going to click on this one, right click and format it. And again, change it to this spot here. I'm just going to hit okay. Oh, that one didn't go. Oh, there it goes. And then, so this last one right here and format control. So now I have them all that are going to be all connected to their own spots here. So now you can see that they're independent of each other. So that's the first step to get those false and true to come up. And then we can start to go and create what the next step would be for this interactive map. So the first step I'm going to do here is actually just copy down this table that I have here of this information. I'm just going to go Control C and go to this spot and Control V. And then I'm going to go ahead and just delete this information because this is where I'm going to be putting my if statement here to say if this is chosen, so if this becomes true, then give me back the Netflix information. So if Disney is true, then it's going to be bringing me back the Disney information. So what we're going to do is start our if statement, and I'm just going to put equals and type if, and you can see checks whether a condition is met and returns one value of true and another is false. So if it's false, it's just going to say false here and won't bring back any information. Now I do have a different tutorial all about if statements. I'll put a link to that down below in the description as well and then in the card. So I'm going to choose this if right here. And the logical test, so it's going to be this first spot right here. So B12 is where the information from Netflix is going to come out. Now, I'm not going to make this an absolute here because I am going to copy this down. But if you didn't have it in a row, if you didn't want to copy things down, you might want to make this absolute. What I mean is use the dollar signs if you don't want it to be moving when you're copying things on it. So, but I'm leaving this as this. I'm going to put my comma. And so, yeah, if the value is true, what do I want to have happen? Well, I want it to bring back this range right through here. So just not one, but the range I want it to bring back. So I'm going to hit enter. So it says false, false is here. I'm going to check it. And now it brings it back just like this. So that's what I want. Now, since I didn't make that absolute, I'm going to copy just this first thing down. So I'm going to just grab the corner and bring it down like this. And notice it says false, false, false. Let's see if it works. Let's click this one and it brings me back YouTube. And we can check to see if that's correct here. Yes. And we can bring it back up here. That looks correct and it's copying it down. So this information is where we're going to be creating our chart from, which makes it interactive when we choose the checkbox that we wish. Now I'm going to keep our chart pretty simple here today, but if you want to learn more about charts in Microsoft Excel, I'll put a link to one of my videos where I explain the different types of charts and how to customize them. But for our purposes here today, this is going to be the information that we're going to chart. So I'm just going to select this range in here. And if we're under insert, you can see that we do have recommended charts. So I could go ahead and click on this and it comes up. You could use a different chart than the one I showed you. You could pick one. I'm just going to go to all charts and I'm going to use a combo one here. So combo is at the very beginning and you'll be able to see now some of these are clustered column. I'm going to choose each of these to a line with markers. So I'm just going to go through and change each of these like this. So I'm going to have four different ones that when they show up, and I'm just going to go ahead and hit okay right now and move this over closer, and let's just check it out. There's other things that we can customize this with, but let's just check out the check marks here. And you can see now, if I say true here, now I'll turn it off and Disney disappear, turn it on again, and it goes on. So you can, it quickly updates based on this, because this if statement here is going to be connected to these true and falses that you choose. Now, if you want to customize your different charts, you can go through and choose different ones. So if you do want to have your access titles, you can go through, and I knew this is, I had this in billions here, so I'm just going to put this as billions here, just like so. And you can give it a chart title, so this, I'm just going to grab my up here, grab this information from the title here and just copy and put it over here. And I'm going to paste it in here just like this. So there we have a title. We have a little bit of access title here. We don't want that. I could put quarters if I want to go ahead and add that. I'm going to hit delete just so I have a little bit more room. We can go through and make some changes to this. You can see how quickly you can make some changes. I believe I was using the black one like this. A little bit different with the color lines than one I had on the first page, the sheet one, but you can kind of go through and choose which ones. Now I could go ahead and just write these names down here, but I want to go and get the graphics. So I just want to change the size of these real quick. So I'm just going to change these rows, the height to a different one, the row height. I believe it's 25 should work. And you notice that the check marks kind of stay in place. So I have to right click on them. And now I'm just going to line them up a bit more. So right click and bring them down to get them in the right spot. One more here. And I'll just bring this one down like so. And this one will be the last one that I go through. So we have these here. Let's go get some of these. So what you can do to select all of these at once, you can go and get the, if there was different graphics that you're using, you can copy paste them from somewhere or insert them. But what I'm going to just take from here. So I'm going to just hold down shift and select each one here. And you can see that they get highlighted as I select all of them. I'm just going to go control C and go over to sheet two, and I'm just going to bring them back over to here and kind of line them up. So this kind of works like they're in the right spot. The other thing I have said I was going to mention to you is we don't want to see the true here. We can see everything's working now. Everything's interactive. As I click on different ones, you're getting that dynamic change to it. But if we don't want to see these, a quick way what you can do is if I go ahead and just change the color of this font. So if I'm just going to highlight these, go up to font color, and I'm going to make it white. It's still there. But what I can do at this point, if I go ahead and just right click, I can bring this cell right over top now. So it's going to be over top of where I place the cell that is connected to. So I can bring them back over here, and we'll just bring this last one back over. And now everything will still work. As I click on it, it's still interactive. It's being hidden underneath. Now I could have put that true and falses to a different place, and then even chose to hide a certain column if I wanted to do from that. But in this case, I just changed it to the white font and put them in the exact same place. Now there's a lot of different things you can do with the checkboxes. This is just one example. I'd really be curious to know what other things you're trying to learn with the checkboxes or Microsoft Excel. Let me know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.